Amen, amen. Praise the Lord. It's good to be here this morning. I'm glad because it's because of his grace and his mercy. I thought about that. I said, boy, I didn't have to be here this morning, but I'm glad because he saw it fit. He says, no, I got to let this girl get up again another morning. And I'm so grateful. And if you're out there this morning, you didn't even say thank you yet, do it. It's not too late. Give him some praise. Because realizing that you could have been gone, not here breathing, and you're here, that's a lot to give him thanks this morning. Amen. Let's look to the Lord in prayer. Father, we're so thankful this morning because you're good. And it says your mercy endureth forever. This morning, dear God, as we go through our devotion, we thank you right now for taking us through it. Bless the hearts as we listen. I'm speaking to myself as well. And we're glad because you're the Lord of Lords. Take us through to this morning. We give you thanks, Lord, and we give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Minister Angela, I could have sat here this morning and just listened to that song. I'm glad that God did not throw the clay away. Oh, my Lord. What would I have been doing if he did throw that clay away? I'm glad I'm molded in him this morning, and I know you are too. I had to dry up those tears real fast because I didn't want to be online and crying and say, what is she crying for? You know what I'm crying for this morning? I'm going to share with you, step up higher in him. But when I think of when I step up, what is ahead of me? I say, oh. But you see, I trust him so much that I have a made up mind to go up higher in him. So this morning, step up higher in him. You might not want to move as fast as you should, but think of the goal that is set ahead. It's like we were in school and we said, all right, you see that line over there? Let's see who first gonna get there. So we're gonna build up the courage and we're gonna step forward to reach that goal. Let's go into 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 18. And I'm still in my New King James Version. Let's see what it says to us. But we all with unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror, the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. We have intended a place to climb. And let's make that move now. We've been sitting down in our comfort zone for a very long time. You could say that about yourself. I could say it about myself. But it's time to move. So let's see if we can step up higher in him this morning. Some of us get to do this and we are dragging. We are doing it so slow. But I'm going to encourage you this morning. Get some quality in your step and see if it makes a difference. I remember when I was through with my surgery and they sent me to the rehab. And one of the things I had to do was step up on some stairs. And guess what I did? When they showed me the stairs, say, you see those stairs over there? Yes, ma'am. I want you to try and get up those stairs. I said, okay, no problem. But then I bowed my head and I whispered, I said, God, you brought me through that surgery. There's no pain. So guess what? You see those stairs over there? Let's go. I guess you're laughing, but that's exactly how I said it. I said, God, let's go. And I went over to the stairs. Put my hand on the railing, and I said, feet, God say, let's go. And I started stepping up and higher and higher and higher until I got to the top. When I got to the top, the therapy nurse looked at me. She said, "Oh my gosh, are you okay? You're not tired?" I said, "No, ma'am." She said, "Okay, now we are going to come down on the other side." I didn't really want to come down. I was up high. I could see everything. But I had to show her that I could do it. And I started stepping down back to normal. But let me tell you something this morning. When you step up in God, you don't want to come down. It doesn't feel nice coming down. You want to stay up there, where you could breathe the fresh air and you could see what God is showing you. So let's go over to Acts chapter 1 and verse 8. And let's see what it says. It said, "But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. And you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth." We are given the authority by the Holy Spirit. No one else. It's just the Holy Spirit. As it starts letting us step up in Him. You know how we're going to start stepping up in Him? Number one, let's do some more praying. Sometimes we go to pray and it's just a little thing and then we're done and we're gone, do whatever else. I could remember when I was a little girl, my grandmother started us in the living room at 5 o'clock in the morning. I had to get up and we're having family devotion. And the first thing she taught us was that Our Father that is in Matthew. And each of us had to say it. It was four of us, her grandchildren, sitting there with her. And we had to say it. We learned it. But then after we got older, she says, "Okay, you listen to us pray. Figure out what you want to tell God for yourself this morning." And we started to pray. And it felt good. Because guess what? I felt big and I was praying for myself this morning. I didn't have to wait for my grandfather or my grandmother or my auntie to pray. But I was able to say more than they taught me. And that made me feel good. So this morning, you haven't started to step up, start out with your prayer. Next thing I want you to go so we could help you to step up. We're doing some fasting. I remember we had our fasting not too long. And let me tell you something. There's so much things that comes out of fasting. You don't even want to stop. Especially if you're doing it sincere to God. Not to you or somebody else around you. But you're there telling God, "God, I'm stepping up in you. Do this for me and I thank you." Thank Him for taking you up there. And the next thing you got to do, read His word. And study. Now, don't read it. "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures." No, study what that is saying. He is your shepherd. And you don't really want to just run through the lines of that scripture. You want to dissect it, as we say in science class. Let's dissect it. Let's go piece by piece and see what that scripture is saying to us. So you're going to start stepping up by praying, fasting, reading, and study His word. Then let's not forget we got to praise Him every chance we get. Give Him some praise. He is worthy of our praises. Then we also want to witness. We just don't want to pass by somebody in the street and they're looking at us, and you have an opportunity when they look at you. I know when I was small and you used to see people, they say, "I want to talk to that person, but I'm so scared." No, you got to have some courage. You got to trust God to take you through it. Because guess what? When you start witnessing, you're stepping up higher in Him. Amen? When you see that all these things are happening for you and you say, "Boy, I should have been doing this a long time ago." But you see, everything has its own timing. But you have to let God control and let Him take you through the desires of your heart. So now you say, God, I want to step up in you. So he's pushing you through the channels as you step up higher in him this morning. As we look through the scriptures and we see how we step up in him, we say, but I didn't know that is how we got to do it. But this we do know, that seeing the height we are trying to measure ourselves up to, his grace and his mercy is going to take us through. It's getting heated now, you know. We are getting hot. But don't start slackening off because you're getting hot. This is the time you're going to push higher. Continue now to climb higher and higher in him. Now we are going to listen to what he's saying to us now in Mark chapter 16 and verse 15. And he said to them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Now step up a little higher now and move on. Whatever God had laid out for you, get to it. And don't let anybody drag you back as you're going up. You know, sometimes some people get jealous of what you're doing and they try to, you know, do things to get you to back it up. Don't back up. Keep going higher in him. Another thing that is going to pull you from stepping up higher, fear. Don't let an ugly world, don't let a world mess with you. Fear will make you shake in your body. Oh, Lord, I can't make it. Yes, you can. Let it happen. Just keep stepping up and then start working harder with your steps. You have the kind of quality steps that you need. Move on up higher in him. Amen. You don't want to drag your feet anymore. You're going to be stepping. You know, like when I was small, I was 12 years old, and my dad said to me, if you pass in school, I'll give you exactly what you want. I already knew what I wanted. So he said, what do you want? And Sister Angela, I know you remember those little timber heels. And you walk in church as a little girl, you want to hear your foot say, cap, cap, cap. And I say, okay, I'm 12. I'm going on 13. I want me my timber heel to go to church. And he says, okay, all this time I already know I passed because I'm an A student. But I didn't say nothing to him. I say, he going to issue that money out. And we go into BATA shoe store and we going to get that timber heel shoe. I sure did. And let me tell you something. When I put that shoes on and I step up Cock Hill Church stairs, I step inside. Everybody look back at me because all they're hearing is step, step, step. And it made so much noise because it was those timber heels. But I was happy because I moved up from 12 and now I'm 13. So keep on stepping up in Christ. Let's see what Philippians chapter 4 and verse 13 says. Guess what it says? I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Keep on stepping higher in him. Right now we are feeling tired, stressed, and the strain from stepping higher. Don't let it discourage you. Trust God and keep on stepping up. Don't look back. Keep looking forward. It's getting better. When we realize where we are, we're going to step even higher in him. Now we are really feeling loyal with the activity, and our whole being is in it, and we're working good. You are really dedicated now. You're saying, yes, Lord, keep me going, God, keep me going. The pressure is happening. As you practice, you will make it. I could remember when I was in school as a young girl, and we have a place in Munster called the Sturge Park. That's where we carry all our sports. And as a little girl, I used to run so fast, no matter who they put next to me, I would make it because I was determined to touch that ribbon. So this morning, if you're looking forwards, and there's that ribbon in front of you, push Trust him, but let him control you as you go, and you will make it to that ribbon. Amen. Sometimes you say to yourself, I don't know if I could do it. Yes, you can. Have a made up mind and let God take you through your situation, and you will be all right. If you are going and you're stopping, check yourself. Say, am I praying enough? Am I studying his word enough? Am I really fasting, taking out what's that supposed to be there and let God control me? Think about it. Give yourself a quick check and just keep stepping up in him. You want to improve it? Step a little harder. Push some more. Because guess what? God's not going to leave you alone. He's going to take you higher as you let him take you higher in him. Those of you out there this morning, you say, I can't do it. Yes, you can. The only how you're going to make it, ask God to come into your heart. Say, God, I want to be able to step up in you this morning like the others are doing. And just don't say it because you want to say it. Say it and mean it. Accept him this morning as your personal savior. One thing you must keep in mind, when you do get to be stepping up, don't ever look back. Just keep on stepping up in Christ, because your altitude determines your attitude. Have a good attitude as you step up higher in God. God bless you this morning.